Today I want to talk about Jalil Farooq and DeMarco Murray is trying to buy a baseball team. And all that's coming up after the bumper.
Don't be cornering me. Hold up. Time. You gotta help me with that corner sh**.
What's up, kinfolk? It's RJ Young. I am not on a step mill. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. So it's college football related, sports related. We have a good time. Today, I want to talk about Jalil Farooq and DeMarco Murray. I'm going to start with DeMarco Murray because I think that's the most interesting news out of all of this, which is DeMarco Murray has joined Jennifer Lopez and Alex Rodriguez in trying to purchase ownership of the New York Mets, along with Brian Urlacher, Travis Kelce, and others. Like, it's a star-studded field of people that I think is going to be made up of a bunch of minority owners to try to overwhelm the Wilpons into awarding them the team. Now, depending on whether or not you believe the New York Post or the ESPNs, where I got most of this information, ESPN reports that the ownership bid that they have put in is $1.7 billion. Steve Cohen, who has tried to buy the team once before but wanted immediate control over it, and then Wilpons balked at that, has put in a bid for like 1.2, but he also has bid in for SNY, which is the television network. Now, over at the New York Post, we think that Steve Cohen actually has a higher bid of like $2.6 billion. Either way, it's going to change hands. It's about whether or not it changes hands to this group that is led by Alex Rodriguez, Jennifer Lopez, like the dude that started Vitamin Water and owner of the Florida Panthers, or Steve Cohen. Now, I find it interesting that DeMarco Murray is a part of this group of people who's trying to buy ownership into this team. Now, I think all of us aspire at some point or another to own some portion of a professional sporting franchise, especially at the high level like Major League Baseball or the NFL. Good luck with that one. NBA, right? I've even had like quiet dreams of like a WNBA squad because I think that would be the most fun to be an owner in. I just do. But DeMarco Murray also just took the job as the running backs coach at Oklahoma a year after he got into coaching altogether at Arizona as the running backs coach. And he has had a very quick rise to this position. This is usually a job that takes 3, 4, 5 years to even get a sniff at. And he got it almost certainly on the strength of what he was able to do both as a player and how good he is as a personality and getting along with people, because many of you know that he was the NFL's leading rusher at one point in time with the Dallas Cowboys. He's one of the best running backs to come through Oklahoma and genuinely considered a top-tier talent of the 10s when we're talking about running backs in the NFL. And looking at how he has been welcomed into Oklahoma's fold, the only thing that we're really waiting on is, where are the recruits, dog? Like, no shade, but DeMarco Murray ain't brought in no Kamar Wheatons and brought in no LJ Johnsons, you know? No shade, but hey, kind of need some running backs here at the University of Oklahoma because trying to compete and win football games here. And after, losing Jace McClellan to Alabama and only getting Seth McGowan in the 2020 class, probably need to get 3 running backs. I haven't seen any commitments. All I've seen is, you know, DeMarco Murray trying to go buy stock in the New York Mets, which is cool, but it's July, and recruiting is going on. Recruiting is happening. Ohio State got a 4-star and a 5-star tailback. Trevion Henderson, Evan Pryor. You know, like Will Shipley's headed to Clemson. Hello. Yeah, I'm just Corey Klein headed to LSU. And Kamar Wheaton's still out there. LJ Johnson's still out there. Need DeMarco to come on. And instead, I got to read about not DeMarco Murray securing commitments, but DeMarco Murray trying to buy in stock in New York Mets, which is trash baseball team. Like, it's the Mets. Why would you want to own the Mets? I guess if you're trying to own any squad, then like most people are, then you try to own any squad. But the Mets is trash. The Mets have been trash. The Mets have been trash since 1986. We make jokes about the Mets. Why are you trying to buy in the Mets? Go get a commitment for the running back class. What are you doing? Marco, we try to be on your side, dog. But Jamar Cain out here getting W's. Y'all both got here at the same time. Clayton Smith is in the boat. Nathan Rollins Cabanj is in the boat. We got defensive linemen in the boat. We ain't got no running backs in the boat. And that's the RBU. What you doing? Come on, what you come on. That's all I'm saying. Come on, what you come on. What we got to do here? Look, if it didn't make the paper and it didn't make the ESPNs, we ain't here now. But it did. And you in your first year at Oklahoma. I'm saying, man, just a level of respect here. Some respect here for what we trying to get done here. Ain't been no national championships here in 20 years, dog. You ain't win no national championship. All right, Jalil Farooq. Reset. Usa. Use fresh points. Okay. Look like Jalil Farooq is got another crystal ball headed to Oklahoma. Brian Doan coming in hard with this one. This Brian Doan has been paying attention to the Mid-Atlantic area in a very real way. You know, Jalil and Caleb Williams are very tight. Jalil Farooq also gets a comp to Riley Ridley, which is not a terrible thing at all. 6'1", about 200 pounds, shifty, can move in space. Coming out of Dr. Henry Wise, where he's kind of set the world on fire. And I'm interested to see how this goes because obviously Oklahoma wants to take maybe even three wide receivers, but I know two for sure, right? Because Cody Jackson's in the boat. And then we're talking about Jalil Farooq and maybe Emeka Egbuka, although I think you just make room for Egbuka. If you ended up with three before him, you're gonna invite Egbuka in there. But as Oklahoma continues to try to fill out this class and tries to continue to compete for a top 10 ranking, it looks harder and harder to do until they get another high major, another high four-star or five-star commit, particularly at the offensive positions, because that's really where it's going to come from. Oklahoma getting five-star defensive talent it feels like it's impossible. Like, it feels way more difficult than it should be, and yet that's where Oklahoma is. So Jalil Farooq got a crystal ball headed his way. I know that my colleagues, Colin Kennedy and Brandon Drum over at 247, have already put in their crystal balls after visiting with him in D.C. where they were on site for Caleb Williams' commitment announcement that was on CBS Sports HQ. And I think as long as Caleb Williams is tight with him and Oklahoma continues to recruit him, it could end up as a win. That said, he's taken more trips to Maryland than he's taken anywhere else. Obviously, it's his home state school, and Mike Locksley is doing a good job of trying to get him in the boat. He wants to get to Ohio State. He wants to get to Oklahoma, but in this age that we don't know whether or not you're even going to be able to take your visits, it's interesting to see how all these kids are dominoing and committing off the Zooms. So perhaps Jalil Farooq commits off the Zooms, but we will have to see what the Zooms indicate for one Jalil Farooq. All right. DeMarco Murray, get back to work. Doses.